there. Shut that thing up. Bigger? Get up from there now.
Yeah, I'll get up.
Lady, you get up too now. Get up. Buddy! You two there. Y'all know I got a big washing on my hands today. I want y'all out of here. You boys turn your head now. I mean, very good dress. Bigger, kill it!
Relax, girl. The thing's dead. It can't hurt you now. It can't hurt you now.
You stop that, boy. You know this child been bit twice before in her life by rats. Suppose you wake up one morning dead. Nothing like that ever seemed to bother you. Now get that thing out of here. Clay, you done turned 19 now. I don't know what in God's name the matter with you, Bigger Thomas. Dear Lord, we thank you for this food, the nourishment of our bodies, for Christ's sake. Amen. You're gonna have to get up earlier than this if you want to hold the job.
You want me to pour you some coffee?
Yeah. You're not gonna forget you have to see Mr. Dalton today at 4 o'clock. You sitting there like you're not going for that job. You're gonna come to a bad end. You keep hanging out with that no-count gang of yours, Bigger. And you're not gonna mount to nothing without that job. Fix up a nice place for you and Vera and Buddy. Y'all can live comfortable and won't have to live like this.
You've been saying the same thing over and over. I done heard that 1,000 times, Mama.
I don't want you to forget, son.
You know how you can forget, Bigger.
Lay off from Vera. Be such a great chance for us, Bigger. Maybe then we can get things back the way they was before your daddy died. He used to hold out such hope for you, Bigger.
I need car fare, Mama.
That's all I got. If you don't get that job, Bigger, relief's gonna cut us off. We won't have no food! Bigger! I just don't understand what is wrong with you.
Big, got a cigarette? Kind of warm out, huh?
Warm, it's 25 degrees.
15 yesterday. Get more heat from the sun than you do from them radiators at home.
Yeah, let's walk. Can't take too much more of this heat wave.
Bigger.
Hey, baby.
I thought you was coming by the other day.
I got busy. You know how it is.
No, I don't know how it is. I gotta catch my train. I'm late for work.
I'll be by. I promise.
Excuse me if I don't hold my breath.
What you laughing at, fool?
Hey, man, you gonna mess around and lose that woman.
I wish I could be up there like that. I'd go so far away from here.
Forget it.
I could fly one of those things if I had a chance.
Yes, sir.
I could.
Yes, sir.
Go to hell.
President Roosevelt.
Yes, I'm the president.
The Secretary of State, Gus. I'm calling the meeting this afternoon at 4. I'd like you to be there.
Mr. President, that's gonna be kind of tough. I got a busy day, and the Germans are raising sand in Europe, the Japanese are raising sand in China.
And the niggas is raising sand all over America.
They is. I'll be right there.
Damn it to hell.
Hey, man, how can you worry yourself like this? Just water, it'll dry off.
They won't let us do nothing, man.
Who?
You don't understand nothing I'm trying to say to you, do you? Sometimes I feel like something awful's gonna happen to me. Nothing ever happens to us.
What you want to happen?
Anything.
What's the matter with you? I thought you were gonna take that job over them white folks this afternoon.
Yeah, maybe take more than a job from them.
Man, I'm telling y'all, we can do this.
Oh, Bigger.
Man, it was your plan to start off with.
Bigger, we ain't talk about that for a month. Why are you bringing it up now?
I'm saying it's easy. We can go in there and clean the place out.
When Blum keeps a gun behind the counter, you forget. Suppose he beats us to it.
I'm scared. That's all.
It's a white man, and y'all scared.
I'm with you, Bigger.
Say you got it all figured out?
It's easy. Between 3 and 4, ain't nobody there but old man.
I'm in.
Where?
If y'all gone, I'm gone.
Yeah. Ain't no little scared rat. Don't be calling me out my name. I don't work for you.
Use your tongue. Black son of a bitch.
You see, Bigger? You done caused all the trouble we have around here. It's your hot temper. You ain't had to call me out of my name. I got the right to make up my own mind.
Tom. You ain't nothing but scared.
You the one that's scared. You scared I'm gonna say yeah, and you gotta go through it.
We're meeting back here at 3. All of us!
Life is like a mountain railroad, with an engineer that's the way. We must take the run successful from the cradle to the grave. Mountain railroad with an engine that's going. We must make the run successful.
Bigger?
From the cradle to the grave.
Just as soon go to jail as take that damn relief job.
Well, they do. You know, there's no denying the fact that God has a way
with it. You think white folks really live like that?
Sure. So why would they put it in the movies?
What if that white man I'm supposed to work for is rich like that?
Maybe so.
We will soon fix Irene. Godfrey will take care of everything. Just sit right down there like a good girl, and in just a minute, you'll forget that you had any trouble.
Go, go!
I got a good mind to take that job.
Sure. You don't know what you might see. Hey, man. Let's go.
I swear, man, he makes us miss his job. It's gonna be me and him.
Relax, man. He'll be here.
Man, I told you I'd be here.
You late!
Hey, what's going on back there?
Nothing, Doc. We just talking.
It's after 3. You late. We can't do it now.
You're such a punk. You make me sick.
You're the one that's scared. You just use me for an excuse because you're the one that's scared because you don't want to go through it with me. You scared.
Vicar, let him go.
Leave me.
Such a clown, Gus. Get up. Sit down over there. Next time, you won't be late.
It ain't too late, Vicar. We still got time.
Shut up. It's late.
Okay, Vicar, that's enough. It's over.
Go ahead and laugh. That's all right. Vicar, you crazy? What the hell's wrong with you?
If I ever catch you back here again, you're gonna be dead before God gets the news. Now get out of here.
Come on, take a seat. I'll tell Mr. Dalton you're here.
Yes.
Thomas, come this way. Come this way.
Yes, sir.
Follow me, Vicar.
Henry?
Elaine, are you all right? Where's Peggy?
Preparing dinner. I'm perfectly all right, Henry. Is there someone with you?
Oh, I'm sorry. This is the new boy the relief people sent.
Vicar Thomas, I hope you'll be happy here.
Yes. Where's Mary?
In her room. There's a book she wants to finish before tonight's lecture. Our daughter is a university student. How far did you get in school, Vicar?
8th grade, ma'am.
Well, we'd like to see you go back and finish your education. The man who used to work here went to night school. His name was Green, and he was very diligent. It took him 10 years, but he got his high school diploma and his college degree. Now he has a nice government job, the first colored man in his office. Well, you could do the same thing.
I don't know, ma'am.
We were on the way to the library, ma'am.
The relief people suggested it would be a good idea if he were put in his new environment right away.
Well, we'll see. We'll see.
How old are you, Bigger?
19, ma'am.
Oh, the same age as our Mary. Welcome to our home, Bigger.
You want some more?
No.
But if you change your mind, just yet.
Ma'am.
Oh, did Mr. Dalton tell you about tending the furnace?
No, ma'am.
Well, it's easy. I'll show you when you're done. This is a swell place. As good as you'll find anywhere. I've been working here 20 years myself.
Yes, sir.
I was always one for sticking to a job. You know, Mr. Dalton's done a lot for your people.
My people?
Oh, yes, the colored. He's given over $1 million to colored schools. But everything is simple here. They've got millions, but they act like human beings. They don't put on airs and strut. And Mrs. Dalton thinks people should behave.
Yes, ma'am.
You know, I wasn't in this country but a brief spell before I started working here. It was right before Mary came along. Mary, you haven't met her yet?
No.
She's just back from Europe. She's very bright. She's cute as a button. It's kind of wild that she got back from Europe. Worries her folks to death, she does. She's been running around with a crazy bunch. Some of them commie reds.
Reds?
Yeah. She don't mean nothing about it. She's been around the world, but she don't know a thing about it.
Yes, sir.
You see? It's easy as 1, 2, 3. Now, you have to remember to empty the ashes out very often, otherwise the furnace gets clogged. You just shake them up and put them... You just shovel the ashes in the bucket there and leave them outside.
Yes, sir.
Okay? This was Green's room. He's a colored man before you.
Who else gonna sleep here?
Just you. I don't know if these are going to fit right. Let's see. Ah, well, we'll fix it next week. I think you're going to like it here.
My daughter, Mary.
How do you do, Bigger? Very nice to meet you. I hope we're going to be friends.
Mary, try not to be too late coming home from school. Your mother worries.
Don't you worry too, Daddy?
You know I do.
I think we'll be all right, right, Bigger? Say, Bigger, do you belong to a union?
Oh, no, Mary.
All right. I'm going. I'm going.
Is the University School on Midway, ma'am?
Yes. You drive well, Bigger.
Yes, ma'am.
Bigger.
Ma'am?
I want you to turn right up there. To the left there. Bigger, Bigger, I want you to turn there.
But, ma'am, that's not the way to your school.
Yes, but I'm not going to school.
Ma'am?
I want you to drive me to the loop.
I can't do that, ma'am. Your father told me
Come
I was
on,
supposed...
Come on, Bigger, you're not a telltale, are you?
No, ma'am.
I want you to take me to the loop, but if anyone asks you, say I went to the university, see?
Yes, ma'am.
Right.
That's the way you want it, ma'am.
I knew I could trust you. After all, I'm on your side, right, Bigger? Bigger, pull up right in front of that building over there.
Ma'am, this place is full of reds.
Oh, Bigger, you should hear yourself.
Ma'am!
I'll be right back. Bigger, I want you to meet Jan. Jan, this is Bigger Thomas.
How are you, Bigger?
Fine, sir.
First of all, you don't have to call me sir, but I'm Jan and you're Bigger.
He means that, Bigger.
Listen, why don't you let me drive for a while?
No.
No, it's okay.
I mean, I can't. Mr. Dalton said I'm supposed to drive the car.
It's all right, Bigger. It's as pretty in Chicago as it is any place in the world.
I'm so glad you're back. You see that building over there? My father and about 50 other guys built it. One day while on the job, my father took a bad fall and he wasn't able to go back to work. A man came to my mother, gave her a check for 2 weeks' pay. But things will be different after the revolution. I'm Bigger.
We seem strange to you, don't we, Bigger?
No, ma'am.
Where do you live, Bigger? I want to know things. There's so much I don't know yet. Your people mind, they don't know each other.
Say you want to eat?
Mm-hmm.
Where should we go, Bigger? What do you think? Someplace maybe where... someplace where...
Where do you eat, Bigger?
Marinese.
Sounds good.
That sounds great. Can we park over there?
Yes, sir.
Look, Bigger, please don't call me sir. We're both men, okay?
Yes, sir.
Aren't you coming?
Come on, Bigger. You must be hungry.
No, I'm not.
Well, come sit with us.
It'll be all right.
I gotta watch the car.
Oh, come on, to hell with the car.
I'm not hungry, ma'am.
Look, if you're not going, we're not going, okay?
Listen, you know, you don't have to come in. We may not be saying things the right way. We don't want to make you feel bad. Come on, let's go. You want to ask her over?
I got it.
No, she's over there already.
I'll be right back. Okay.
This is good.
This year our bird's real gone. Did I say that right, Bigger?
Yeah, that's how they say it.
Bigger, where were you born?
Mississippi.
You like Chicago?
Yes, ma'am.
You live with your folks?
My mother, my brother, and my sister.
What about your dad?
He was in a riot down south when I was a kid. Got killed.
What happened to the men who killed him?
Nothing.
Nothing. Well, how do you feel about that?
I don't know.
But you see, that's what we're trying to stop. We feel that everyone should be treated fairly, and that means everybody, all people.
There's a lot of white people in the world.
We want to be friends with you, Bigger, really get to know you.
sir, can't be. You'll get used to us.
Oh, Baker, by the way, I have to go to Detroit tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock. If you pick up the trunk at 8:30, we can take it to the station. Tell Father he'll let you make up your time.
Yes, ma'am. I mean, Miss Dalton.
You know the words to this song. Sing up. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry you home. Right after that, the police arrested three of our demonstrators.
Who?
Well, there was a YCLer and these two college women. Max and I have been trying to raise bail money all day.
Well, how much do you need?
$3,000.
Okay. I can take care of that.
Mary, you're a brick.
Well, here comes my train.
Why don't you let Bigger take you home?
Why should he drive me all that distance at this time in the morning?
Bigger.
It's been a pleasure.
Sir.
Listen, I'd like you to take a look at some of our pamphlets are from our organization. I think you'll like them.
Yes, sir.
I'll talk to you in a couple of days. Mary,
I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Take good care of Mary, won't you, Bigger?
You see, Bigger, in 3 hours, you didn't have to say yes, sir, or no, sir, or yes, ma'am, or no, ma'am. Stick with us, kid. We'll straighten you out.
We're here. Miss Dalton. Ma'am? Miss Dalton, ma'am, we...
Here, man. I just want you to know I am not drunk.
I
Mary? Are you all right? Mary? Mary, dear. You aren't asleep, are you? I hear you moving above.
Smells of alcohol. Mary, you've been drinking again.
Thank you.
What's the matter with you, boy?
Nothing.
You jumped like something hit you. You got the job?
Yeah.
What they paying you?
20.
You started already?
Last night.
You want something to eat?
No, I can go.
You gotta go already? You know what? I guess you'd be needing some coffee.
No.
Here you go, baby.
Thank you, Mom.
Bigger? Glad you got the job, son. It's a man's responsibility. You take care of yourself now. Yeah, baby. I was just going to put some more coal on the fire.
I'll fix it, ma'am.
Is Miss Dalton down yet?
I'm studying.
Well, you see to the fire, baby. Miss Dalton will be down soon. You have to take her to the station.
Yes.
Is this her trunk here?
Yes, ma'am. She told me to bring it down last night, ma'am.
Don't forget it.
She's not out yet?
No, ma'am.
Wait here a minute. She ain't here. Maybe she's gone. What did she say to you?
Nothing but what she said last night, ma'am.
Well, take the trunk to the station. Maybe she didn't stay here last night. Well, the boy didn't see her in the station, neither. Sent a trunk on to Detroit, though.
I tell you, Peggy, I don't understand it. Something's wrong. I felt around in there. Mary didn't finish packing her trunk. At least half her things are still in the wardrobe. A lot of them that she bought especially for her trip to Detroit.
Well, maybe she didn't go.
Well, then where is she?
Thank you.
Just a minute.
Mr. and Mrs. Dalton have some business to attend to. They won't need you until at least two.
Yes,
ma'am. Run out. No sense of staying cooped up in here.
Hey, babe. You gonna let me in?
Listen, Eddie. Your white friends grow tidy and throw you out.
Bessie, please.
Least you could have said hello, dog.
I swear, Bigger, you ain't got no respect for me at all.
But it ain't true. You're the only woman I care for.
It hurt like hell last night, Bigger. You acted like you was too ashamed for me to be around you and your hanky white friends.
It wasn't my friends. I work for that white girl's family.
Good.
Then you can just work yourself right back where you came from.
Not that I came all this way. Friends, too.
Bigger, I don't know.
Just be with me.
You're gonna destroy me someday, Vigor. I know it. I just know it.
Oh, I ain't gonna hurt you. Thought you knew that.
So where you working?
4600 Block Drex.
Near where the Loeb family used to live.
Who?
You know. From that Loeb-Leopold trial?
Hmm?
You know, when them two rich kids killed that Frank's boy and sent the note to the family to get money. Like they needed money. Oh. So now you want to get romantic, huh? Well, they're just like you, Bigger. I don't never see you except when your love come down. Don't you know how much I miss you when you're gone? I work too hard to be treated bad by you. Where you been? What can I hear from you?
What's going on? You know that girl I work for? She got a millionaire daddy. She went and run off with some communist guy. Last night, I went up to her room and I took this money. And there's more where this came from.
What you say?
We can get us some real money, Bessie. $10,000.
Speaking
of, we're gonna need money for us someplace.
I don't understand you. You talking about kidnapping?
It ain't kidnapping. The girl at Loeb's.
Suppose that girl come back.
She won't.
Well, how you know?
I just know she ain't gonna come back.
No, Bigger, that girl gonna come back.
Damn it, Bessie! Forget about that girl.
Bring the trunk back from the station. Mr. Dalton got a wire from Detroit. Mary never got there.
Sit down, Bigger.
I want you to meet Mr. Britton. He's a private investigator.
I want you to take your time, think hard, because I'm going to ask you some very important questions. What time did you take Miss Dalton out of here last night?
about 5:30, sir.
You drove her to school? Come on, boy.
Mister, I just work here.
I asked you a question.
No, sir. No, sir, I didn't drive her to school, sir.
Where'd you take
her? To the loop, sir.
Nigger, why didn't you tell us that before?
She told me not to, sir.
Whereabouts in the loop?
16 Lake Street, sir.
Labor Defender's Office. She was with Arlone, all right. Then what happened?
Then we were driving around. Then they wanted to eat on the south side at Ernie's Kitchen Shack.
How long did they stay there?
You must have stayed there for about...
You ate with them?
Yes, sir. I didn't want to, sir. They made me. But it was my job, sir. He kept after me, and then I went in.
How much they have to drink?
I don't know.
Afterwards, you drove him home?
Yes, sir.
What time was that?
Nearly 2, sir.
How drunk was Miss Dalton?
She passed out, sir.
Go on.
I told y'all that Miss Dalton told me to take her trunk down. I said that because she told me not to tell about taking her to the loop.
It was Mr. Jan told me to bring down that trunk and to leave the car.
What'd he say about the part?
Sir?
Come on, Bigger. Don't stall. You tell me what he said about the party.
It wasn't no party, sir. He made me sit at his table, and he bought me...
Don't! Who's your organizer, comrade?
I don't know nothing about no organizer.
He doesn't know anything. Leave him alone.
Let's go, Arlone.
Look, what is it you want?
Bigger. Is this the man Miss Dalton brought home last night?
Yes. What the hell is this?
Did you see Mary Dalton last night?
No.
You didn't give these books to that boy last night?
All right. I saw her last night. You know why I didn't tell you in the first place.
No, we don't know why.
Come on, you know as well as I do, Mr. Dalton's got no use for me and my friends. I didn't want to get Mary in any trouble.
Then you did meet her last night.
Yes.
And you gave these books to that boy, and you and Miss Dalton got drunk last night, right?
All right, I gave the pamphlets to Bigger. And no, Mary and I were not drunk last night. We had a few drinks, and that was all.
You brought her home about 2.
Yes, it's about 2.
And you told this boy to take the trunk down to the basement.
Say, Bigger, what's this all about? Bigger, what are they trying to do to you? Come on, don't be afraid. Speak up.
Boys told us all about last night, Arlone. So you might as well just forget it.
Where's Mary? Where is she?
My daughter is not in Detroit. No one knows where she is.
Leave him alone. Why did you tell these men I brought Mary home last night?
Forget it, Ormoni. You've been lying ever since you got here. First you say you didn't come here last night, then you say you did. Then you say you weren't drunk last night, then you say you were. You don't even seem sure if you brought Mary Dalton home or not. Now, do you think we're fools? Where's Miss Dalton? Her father and mother want to know.
I'm not telling you anything unless you let me know what's going on right now. I'm leaving. Bigger, don't let him get you down, huh?
Wait a minute. Look, I know that you and I don't agree on things. But this, I want my daughter. I want to know where my daughter is.
I don't know where she is.
I'll make it all right with you.
What?
I'll make it worth your while.
He knows a lot more than he's saying.
I'm gonna call Detroit again.
What did they tell you to make you say those things? But listen, what's this all about? I haven't done anything to you, have I? Where's Mary?
I don't want to talk to you.
Listen, why don't we we'll sit down,
get,
we'll
away.
Get a cup of coffee, we'll discuss this whole thing.
Dad, go away!
What have I done to you?
Leave me alone. You hear me?
Bigger, what's going on?
I got her to write us a note. I got to let them know she's safe.
Bigger, please don't do this. Please don't do this. It's not going to do it.
Shut up, Bessie! You can go to your gym!
I'm scared.
What's the matter with you, boy? Where on earth have you been? I've been waiting your supper for you.
Well, I was in...
There is the chair. Sit down and eat. Be careful of your uniform.
You want some coffee? There it is.
Take this to Mr. Dalton. I'll be back in a minute.
Where'd you get this?
It was under the door.
When?
I don't know. I just found it a few minutes ago. Is anything wrong,
Henry?
Bigger, did you see who left this note?
No, sir.
Henry, what is it?
It's Mary.
She's been kidnapped.
Dalton, any comment on this? Mr. Dalton, please give us something.
I have a statement.
Mr. Dalton,
Jan Erlone says you paid your chauffeur to lie about him.
It's not true.
What about that? There's Mrs. Dalton. Over
hey,
there, please.
Can you make a comment, sir?
I have just phoned the police and asked that Jan Erlone be released immediately.
Why, sir? I don't understand.
I want it known that I will not press charges against him of any kind.
What's
it's important that that be understood. And I regret to tell you that our daughter Mary is... Our daughter Mary has been kidnapped.
And the kidnappers identified themselves.
We have a ransom note.
What are their demands?
How much money?
I will pay them as instructed. The police are not involved.
Is it possible your daughter helped set this up, Dalton? I mean, she's a Red sympathizer, right?
Please, Mary is our only child.
All right.
Well,
can you believe this, huh? How come they wouldn't let us come in upstairs?
Mrs. Dalton doesn't want us tracking up the car.
Say, Mike, you think this Erlone fellow did it?
My name ain't Mike.
Oh, come on, you know it's just a phrase, boy. So what do you think? Erlone do it?
Gentlemen, help yourself.
Oh, hey, great.
Oh, okay. Hey, great.
Bigger, there's not enough heat upstairs. You better clean those ashes out and start a better fire.
Yes.
Hey, I just called the paper. Erlone's got a dozen people who will swear he didn't come here last night.
Yeah, sure. Gonna believe a commie? Everybody knows they'll say anything to protect one of their own.
Say, boy, you better get some of those ashes out of there.
That fire can't get any air, Bigger.
I can do it.
There's a hell of a lot of ashes in there, boy. You shouldn't let it get like that.
Yes, sir.
Hey, open the door.
It's cold in here.
Jeez, you guys. Look at this.
What's the matter?
What is it? What? God, it's a bone.
No, it's just garbage. Oh,
no. It's from a body.
Hey, look. What's this? Something melted.
It's a girl's earring.
Nigga, Bigger Thomas gonna cause me to lose my job and maybe even my life. He made them crackers think we all just like him.
They think that already.
It's a shame what the hell your boy did to that microphone. If I was him, that's what I'd do. We're making the rest of the bad believe.
Hey, there, on Texas.
Thank you.
after it.
Trying to get in here for the last couple of days. I need to talk to you. Maybe I haven't the words to say what I want to say. But I'm going to try. Look, I've been struggling with what happened. Ever since I heard what happened, I felt so angry I could kill. I'm not dumb, Bigger. I know I didn't understand that. I know neither of us understood that night. I guess I just didn't realize how far apart we are. And, now I can see that you could only hate me. Because that's all you had. Look, Bigger, there's a man outside. He's an attorney. He's a friend of mine. His name is Max. I work with him. He wants to help you.
I don't want to see nobody.
Bigger, he'll save your life. Get Max.
No, leave it alone!
I can't!
Listen, Bigger, there's people out there that are gonna kill you unless you do something to stop them.
From the labor defenders. Did Jan tell you? I'm gonna help you, Bigger.
I ain't got no money.
I know that. Have you spoken to another lawyer? Listen to me, Bigger. They're gonna take you to an inquest this afternoon. They're gonna ask you a lot of questions. Remember, you don't have to tell anyone anything. I am the only one you have to talk to. Okay?
On my territory again, huh, Max?
Be nice to my client, Buckley.
Oh, please, Max, no ironies. I got enough evidence to put him in a dozen electric chairs already. You can't help him.
I'm afraid you won't be able to kill him before the April election if I handle the case.
Boy, did you ever think you'd be as important as you are right now? You can't win. Come on.
Well, you're taking him.
See for yourself. Come on. Dalton, I'm just dreadfully sorry.
Have you talked to him? Has he told you anything?
Ma'am?
Did he say who was in this with him?
I think he's just a killer, sir. He's got a lawyer with him now.
Bigger, please tell us who helped you. We've got to know.
He's already implicated our lawyer.
I know. He has an alibi.
All right, you can come in. They have a right to see him.
Bigger! Bigger? Son, is he treating you all right?
Yeah, Mom.
My baby, we so worried about you. The police is standing outside our door night and day, following us around like the dry Pope Buddy and Vera crazy. Bigger, tell them you didn't do it. Just tell me and I'll fix them.
Don't y'all worry about nothing. I'll be out in no time.
All right, Frank, would you please escort these children out?
Come with me. Come on.
Son, is there anything I can do? Anything?
Mom, I'm all right.
I want you to have this. Cause ain't nobody but God can stop your suffering now.
No, Mama.
Bigger, please.
Mama, I can't.
I did everything I know how. And if I left anything undone, it's because I didn't know, because I didn't see. I got down on my knees. And I asked God if I'd done anything to raise you wrong. And I asked him to let me bear your burden if I've done wrong by you. Son, God's done fixed it. God's done fixed it. Don't matter what happened down here. We gonna meet in heaven. But you got to go to him, Bigger. You got to go to God and you got to pray. Promise me.
Okay.
Promise me.
Mama.
It's all I got. Okay. It's all I got.
Pardon, Mr. and Mrs. Dalton, I'm sorry.
You, Mrs. Dalton? Yes?
All right, now, just a minute, Mrs. Thomas. Mrs. Dalton, could you step over here, please?
No, wait. What is it, Mrs. Thomas? Please, ma'am. Please. I know I ain't got no place with you. I know. But please, ma'am, don't let them kill my boy. Please, ma'am, I know you're a mother and you just lost your daughter. Please, ma'am, don't let them kill my boy.
There's nothing.
Please, ma'am.
Mama, no!
Don't let them kill my boy. He's just a poor boy.
There's nothing.
He's just a poor boy, Miss Dawn. He ain't never had no chance. He's just a poor boy.
Mrs. Thomas.
No, leave her alone. Please try to understand. There's nothing I can do. And you mustn't blame yourself. You have two other children. Got to live for them.
Please. Now. Mr. Dalton. Please, sir, Mr. Dalton. You a rich man. You a rich and powerful man, Mr. Dalton. Please, your peoples, they gonna move us out of our house and we ain't gonna have nowhere to live. We ain't gonna have nowhere to live, Mr. Dalton. Please save my son. Please don't let him kill my boy. Don't let him kill my boy, Mr. Dalton. Don't let him kill my boy. Don't let him kill my boy, Mr. Dalton.
Her fault, we don't blame her.
Okay, Max, we'll see you in the hearing room, huh?
Bigger, don't worry. Remember what I said, I'm the only one you have to talk to.
Come on, have a seat. I know how you feel, boy. You're colored and you think you haven't gotten a square deal, don't you? Maybe you've been thinking about this color question for a long time, huh? You think I don't understand, but I do. I know how it feels to walk those streets out there just like other people. Talking like them, dress like them. But cut off. And the only reason is the color of your skin. And it hurts. Drive you crazy sometimes. Just like this other colored boy I talked to. He raped a woman, just like you raped Mary Dalton.
They raped that girl!
Jan wrote that kidnap note, didn't he?
No.
You wrote the note.
Yeah.
But Jan told you to write it, didn't he?
No. Trying to blame him. Ain't nobody in this but me.
Come on in.
Hello, Bigger. Bigger, you gotta talk to me. Tell me about that night, Bigger.
What you wanna know you don't know already?
Why'd you kill Mary Dalton?
I don't know.
Bigger, it won't do either of us any good if you won't talk to me. Help me. Talk to me, Bigger. You've got to help me defend you. Why did you kill her?
I didn't plan to kill her.
Tell me what happened.
It was an
accident. That don't matter now.
Did you rape her?
No, Mr. Max. Didn't. I can't tell you that. They say black men do that. It don't matter if I did, if I didn't.
You know, Bigger, I would have thought you liked her.
Liked her? I hated her.
What had she done to you?
It ain't like she did nothing straight out. I mean, she asked me a lot of questions. She talked and she acted like she knew me all her life and she didn't know a damn thing about me. I hated her.
I knew her. She was an innocent, rich girl who knew absolutely nothing, nothing about the world. She was harmless.
She ain't heard a damn thing I said. She wanted me to tell her how Negroes live. She wanted to sit next to me in the car.
And you killed her for that?
Yeah, no. I mean, she made me feel like I had a knife in my gut. I didn't know that girl. All I knew was that they kill us for girls like her.
Bigger. Mary was acting toward you the only way she knew how.
And I was acting toward her the only way I knew how. She's just like all the rest of them.
She was trying to help you.
She didn't act like it.
How should she have acted?
Maybe she was trying to be kind. But she didn't act like it. White folks live apart. They smile at you and say, how you doing? And they feel good about it. That's how white folks act.
She wasn't white folks. She was Mary Dalton.
She's the same color as the rest of them. I'm gonna die for knowing that girl.
You wouldn't be worrying about dying. You wouldn't have killed Mary if you'd just told Mrs. Dalton what was wrong as soon as she came to the door of that room. All you had to do was tell the truth.
Wouldn't have made no difference. She was white. I was black. I was dead once I walked into that room. It would all turned out bad no matter what.
White folks, they just want to keep you in that same little spot.
And you didn't want to stay there?
No, I didn't.
I'm gonna try and stop him from killing you, Bigger. They're rushing this trial.
Thomas, will you rise? Your age is 19?
Yes, sir.
If you are found guilty, the court, upon weighing the evidence presented, may have one of three options. To sentence you to a term of not less than 14 years, to sentence you to prison for the rest of your natural life, or to sentence you to death. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Trial will begin 1 week from today.
No, I can't. No.
It must have been a terrible shock to you when you heard about Mary's death.
Yes.
But you told him to read these communist books!
I gave them.
But you did not expect that he would go so far as to rape...
Objection!
...and to murder Mary Goldberg.
No, I mean, I did not expect anything.
Just an ordinary color boy to me. I think he could do anything so horrible.
Objection, Your Honor!
He is the objection, if you ask me.
Mrs. Dalton, can you identify the object I'm placing in your hand?
Yes. My grandmother gave these earrings to my mother on her 18th birthday. My mother gave them to me on mine. Last year, I gave them to my daughter on hers.
Society has a right to protect itself from those who would destroy it. Our children have the right to walk the streets safe from harm, and in order for us to ensure those rights, we must safeguard them through the fullest execution of the law.
Killing Bigot Thomas will not solve a thing. The same conditions that spawned him exist in our streets at this very moment. And if we allow those conditions to persist into future generations, we will come to see a Bigot Thomas murdering on every street corner.
Bigot Thomas, will you rise? In number 666-893, indictment for murder. The sentence of this court is that Bigot Thomas shall die on or before midnight, Friday, March the 3rd, in a manner described by the laws of this state.
Anything I can do for you.
I'm glad I got to know you before I go.
I'm sorry we,
I remember the questions you asked me.
What questions?
That day.
What day?
That day you asked me the questions about myself. You asked me questions nobody ever asked me before. You knew what I'd done, but you treated me like a man.
Of course.
Sometimes I wish you hadn't asked me them questions, because they made me think. I think it's made me scared a little. I saw myself after that night. And I saw the other people too. Mr. Max, I know them folks that sent me here to die, they hated me. They hated me like I hated them. I saw it. I saw us all sitting around and scared to death of each other. I saw them the same as I saw me. You understand? Go on, Mr. Max. I'm all right now.
Bigger.
I ain't gonna cry. They wouldn't let me live, and I killed them. I know something now. Tell my mama I was all right. Tell her I was all right, and I wasn't crying none.
Mr. Matt! Tell Jan I said hello.
I will, Bigger. Goodbye.
Thank you.